Welcome to Core Finance, brought to you in association with Beaufort Securities. I'm joined by leading analyst Matt Brown. Morning to you, Matt.
Morning,
right, we've got a huge number of slides to go through. Let's kick off without further ado. Market movers, the headline, Trump fires communications director, Mr. Mucci. I read that he'd been in the job for 10 days. Just after 10 days, he loses it.
Yep.
Is Trump losing the plot?
Yeah, it looks like it. I mean, he's turning it into one of these Dragon's Den shows where he's firing everyone, you know, one a week. It's a lot going on there. Now, what does this mean for the market? Well, the dollar sold off on the back of this. The FX market doesn't like this. But equities aren't being affected.
Record closed last night on the
day. And all they seem to care about at the moment is earnings. Trump's doing what he's doing in the White House and Capitol Hill, but earnings are strong in the US, and investors are seeing through this. They don't care. Unless Trump is impeached, it's not going to affect the equity markets. And we talk about a Trump bump. Is he really responsible for this incredible rise in the US equity market? I think actually no, because this is key. I mean, this is showing it's all about earnings, and investors don't care what Trump is up to at the moment. It's all about strong, strong earnings coming out in the US.
Let's turn our attention to the UK. FTSE one to watch, Rolls Royce, good news.
Yeah, finally a transitional story here, a bit of a turnaround. They had a bad year last year. There was bribery cases, FX fluctuations, but Warren East is really grabbing Rolls Royce and turning it around. Some good interim numbers. The stock's trading up about 6% this morning, and actually it could be a turnaround story. If you're looking at defence spending from the US and certainly Europe with everything going on in North Korea, that's going to continue. The airlines actually are performing well and orders are strong for aircraft. So actually, Rolls Royce could be a good option to have in your portfolio at the moment.
Understood. Let's talk about the minnows. AIM, one to watch. UK oil and gas, they've been on the show before. Steve Sanderson, we'll try and get him on. Markets rampant.
Great story for UKOG. I think they were trading below 2 pence at the start of the year.
Yep.
Now trading up near 7 pence. Up 25% today. It's on the back of they're getting the rights to continue with their exploratory wells in West Sussex. There's oil in them hills. I know it's your backyard, but it's a good story for UKOG. And this has been a real investor play. They've been teetering around these kind of 1-2 penny mark. You know, it's a penny stock, but now it looks like they're starting or potentially could start to deliver oil. And that's what investors have been looking for. And that's why the stock is storming ahead this morning.
Understood. Let's do some currency headlines. The Great British Pound, Cable 132.07 and Euro Great British Pound 89.48. Couple of headlines on that.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's all about the great weak dollar, not the great British pound. So we've seen that 132 level. Could it go higher? 134, people are now saying. Euro sterling really stuck at this level, and that's the Brexit play. But the big story is dollar weakness, and that's helping cable push higher.
Understood. Let's talk about the core number of the day, 76%. And anyone who can actually work out what that is, I'd be amazed. The headline, over to you.
Ketchup. Apparently, according to Co-op, 76% of the UK public have to have ketchup with every meal. And I assume that doesn't mean breakfast, so we're looking at lunch and supper, dinner. But 76%, that's a huge amount. I mean, I'm sure they don't get it served in a French restaurant and the chef would tell them where to go if they ask for ketchup with their food. But that's incredible. But, I mean, I think if you look at it, it's Heinz Kraft. Obviously, they've got the major ketchup brand. But I think now in Britain, people are looking at the supermarket-owned brands, which are half the price. And when you look at barely managing, if 76 people have to have ketchup, they can't afford a full bottle of Heinz ketchup. They've got to go for the cheaper brands. And maybe that's negative now for the likes of Heinz Kraft, that people will start trading away from their products and looking for cheaper products.
Seller for choice. Okay, let's talk about the economic calendar for the day. Personal consumption in the States, market manufacturing PMIs, and the ISMO manufacturing PMIs again. Not great movers and shakers?
Not really. I mean, I think focus will be on the ISM manufacturing PMI. We've got services PMI coming out from the US and UK later on in the week. Obviously, MPC on Thursday, and the big one, non-farm payrolls on Friday. I think that will draw focus. But it's really, just to round up, as we started at the beginning of the show, it's the political situation in the US that is moving the dollar. That's the FX play. With regards to underlying indices. It's all about the earnings that are coming out of the US and the UK.
Right, so we're all off to to join the strikers at the Bank of England. They've gone on strike, first time in 50 years, apparently 3-day strike. I wonder what Mr. Khan is making of that.
Well, I'm sure he's not striking. He's got a nice pay pack and he's quite happy about that. Good luck to them. Let's see how that goes. But I don't think it's going to affect the Bank of England. They're not going to shut up shop. We'll still get the rate announcement on Thursday.
The Bank of England do, but that's another story for another day. Matt, thank you very much indeed.